the pledge, and Pastor Darrell Sheely from Bay Lake Missionary Baptist Church is going to do the invocation. Everyone rise, please.
Committee and provide provides for duties, membership, facilitation of meetings and procedures, providing for codification and severability, and providing for an effective date.
Can I get a motion to accept the consent agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Any comments or questions, Mr. Ransom?
No.
Any comments or questions, Mrs. Webb?
No, I would, thank you.
Any other comments or questions from the council? Any comments or questions from the public? Okay, hearing none. Mr. Shoebridge, how do you vote?
Aye.
Mrs. Webb?
Aye.
Mr. Smith?
Aye.
Mr. Ransom?
Aye.
And the chair votes aye. There's no old business, new business. Ordinance 2019-51, industrial pretreatment, first reading.
Ordinance 2019-51, and ordinance of the City of Grove, County of Lake, State of Florida, amended Chapter 78 of the Code of Code of Ordinances shall include regulations for all users of the City of Grove's wastewater utility prohibiting introduction of pollutants and other harmful substances into the city's wastewater utility system, requiring compliance with federal, state, or local pretreatment regulations, requiring an individual wastewater discharge permit from certain industrial users prior to discharge into the city's wastewater utility system, providing for enforcement and penalties, providing for conflicts, codification, and severability, providing for an effective date.
Can I get a motion to accept?
So moved.
I'll second.
Any comments or questions, Mrs. Webb?
No, I'm good.
Any comments or questions, Mr. Ransom?
Got all my answers last week, thank you.
Any comments or questions from the rest of the council?
Madam Mayor, I'd just like to say, I think this is a really great move forward, that we're making some change into our water system authority. I know this is before the thing, but hopefully this will allow us to have greater capacity in our plant, because it takes care of some of the problems we've been having, and actions that have been killing off our biomass and doing those other things. So I'm looking forward to seeing this come into play and to make more equitable playing field for all businesses here in the city, so that we're not subsidizing the soot actors that don't seem to be able to meet and follow us. So, good thing.
Any comments or questions from the public?
Hi, my name is Vance Joker. I write the Fiscal Watchdog blog, fiscalrangers.com. I read the details in your packet on this, and I thought it was a great idea that you guys went out and did this study, or the people, the consultants that you were using did that, and found that you had a firm that was dumping a lot of excess garbage, basically, into your system, and that you're going to charge them when they exceed certain standards. I think that's the kind of thing that the taxpayer needs to know, but people are watching where they're spending the money, so I say kudos to the folks that let it go through, and then you have to ask, why wasn't this stopped earlier? Why didn't anybody analyze that, which is always a question sometimes you want to ask. Well, thanks.
Thank you. Any other public comments or questions? So we'll go to council reports. Mr. Shepard.
I'm sorry.
I need to take a vote. I'm just rushing. Mr. Shoebridge, how do you vote?
Aye.
Mrs. Sweat?
Aye.
I'm going to beat my record. Mr. Smith?
Aye.
Mr. Ratzig?
Aye.
And the chair votes aye. All right. Now, public comments. Open forum.
They're happy.
No comments? Okay.
day, except I'm really excited that my UCF Knights are today. I know it had nothing to do with the city, but I'm very excited that my UCF Knights stood the test against Stanford, and looking forward to Pitt this Saturday.
Mrs. Swack?
Well, I was going to lump everything together, since it was mostly just meetings. The pinning ceremony for Chief Ramsey, the Elise Tomlin Community Center had a 9/11 service day, the special council meeting for non-ad valorem. I attended the United Way Lake and Sumter Counties, where the city hosted the housing for all. I attended a Lake League luncheon where Sheriff Pink Rennell was the speaker. He spoke how the effectiveness of the Sheriff's Department during the hurricane that we had. And the only other thing I have is October the 5th, we are having a countywide cleanup. And I found out today that TJ is supposed to be making some arrangements, so I talked with him. But I would like for the city to put it on the website and get some volunteers from the city to help get this Highway 50 cleaned up. And that is all I have.
Mr. Smith?
All right, thank you. Just a couple things. I attended the Lake Harris Restoration Council meeting up in last week, and it was really great. Just a meeting in particular for the city. St. John Board of District folks were there, and we had a nice one to talk about what they do in terms of disaster support and hurricanes or other type of adverse weather, like flooding or so forth, and work with the city manager so we can get them to come in and give a presentation to the council of the assets they could bring to help the city in the event of a natural disaster. Also attended the meet and greet that was put on by the Republican caucus for all the candidates that were here in Lake County this year. So the opportunity to meet with a number of other city candidates that are council members and those that are vying for their seats, so a chance to go out and meet some folks. And lastly, had a great day with the city manager, trying to stack a little bit more on today's neighborhood charity event. Well attended this year. I want to thank all the people that helped sponsor that and bring a little more into the city and since they serve our citizens all too often. Thank you.
Mr. Ranson?
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I finally had an opportunity to sit down and talk to Tim Maslow about vision and where he's concentrating his efforts. It was really a very good meeting, and I continue to look forward to more dialogue. I have a meeting tomorrow at lunch with Hanover. They wanted to go over the CDD. I have a meeting with Wayne Rich on Friday to discuss what's going on with Villa City. And on Friday, we'll be part of the RFP meeting to select a new auditor. We also continue to have dialogue with the city manager and the finance director, and that's all I have.
I went to most of the usual meetings over the last 2 weeks. 2 weeks since our last full council meeting. On the 6th, the city manager and I attended the mayor manager's meeting, and since there was a poor showing, it gave us the ability to kind of take advantage of discussing with the county some issues that have been going on here and trying to get things done. We were able to have our say a little bit more than if we had to share the time with the other cities. I also attended from Anointed Community, the barbecue for the first responders. And then during this past week, I went with our community development director to talk with a business that is just outside of our ISBA and to see some possibilities of them being able to annex it into the city or where we can, to a certain extent, work together. I did not get to go to my book club this past Thursday because I went to a Homes for All symposium here that we hosted, which was very well attended, and a lot of good feedback came from those who attended, and it is an ongoing discussion. We have to find some sort of solutions for housing, affordable housing, also for those who are living out on the streets that they aren't out there anymore and causing more issues. On Friday, I attended the ribbon cutting for the Keys to Learning Center, and they presented Groveland with a, first of all, I got a piece of the ribbon to be added to the other ribbon cuttings that we were to have from over the past year, and the Learning Center gave us a plaque that says Certificate of Appreciation. This acknowledges that the City of Groveland supports our mission to unlock success for all students of all abilities, continued growth and acceptance into our community. The Key to Learning with Dr. Nyman, and it was dated September 13, 2019. I got a chance to talk to Dr. Nyman, and she has graciously offered to have classes or a meeting where she will welcome the council, staff, and the public to come in, and she will do a presentation to explain about more about autism, to understand the large spectrum that in, you know, that it goes to. There's a lot of misconception and incorrect ideas of what goes on in the minds of people with autism, and to be able to relate and get through to some of these children and even adults, because a lot of the adults will never be able to live on their own with this. I don't want to call it a disease, but it is a challenge. So I am looking forward to when she offers the presentation, and I will pass the information along to the public. I have been approached by numerous residents with questions on numerous things. One of the things that they discussed, and I had spoken to Mr. Hine earlier today, the sisterhood from Congregation Sinai is, they usually pick some sort of charity or organization to donate to, and they asked me to what I thought that the city would be behind, and I suggested Faith Neighborhood, which Mr. Hine agreed that seems to be the one that handles a lot of what goes on in the city with the different organizations to make sure food is passed out and clothes and hygiene products and such. If anybody has anything else to add to it, any other suggestions, please, you know, feel free to let me know. Other things are just the typical questions that we all get from the citizens, but I try and reach out to whoever in the city can respond to it about the overgrown grass on right-of-way of areas that are not the city, that it is the county, and try to let them know that we'll reach out to the county. Also, speeding seems to be a big issue that I get usually emails weekly on from different citizens in the city. And there, I am open to any suggestions somebody has on how that can be approached.
Questions on what?
On speeding.
Oh, speeding.
You know, in the different developments or even on the regular streets in the city. But a lot of the people who live in developments seem to feel it's different there. And it's an issue throughout the whole city.
So Chief Ramsey and I, speaking of higher, when I've asked Chief Ramsey or informed him of speeding in Lexington Village, he's come out, he's put in speed radars or what your speed is, and then they've used that to actually put police out there at specific times. So, I mean, that's just for me a standard operating procedures that goes through the chief on it.
Right, I mean, most of them have all done that. And that's why I don't know if we can put a committee together to see if there are different options to go with. I know our officers can't sit there all day long at these different areas, but everyone's afraid that there's going to be a child that's going to be hurt or just a pedestrian. I know in my development in Trilogy, there's a problem at night. There are drivers going too fast, and then the pedestrians are wearing clothes that is too dark that they don't see, and they don't realize. And so it's education for everyone. You know, those are the things. Same thing with cyclists. We have to put something together for that to educate the public. That's it. City Manager's report?
Yeah, Madam Mayor, members of the council, good evening. You have my written report from September 2nd to the 13th, and I'll be happy to answer any questions. I do have a few additional things I'd like to add. First of all, you all received an email earlier today. I authorized an incentive pay program for the fire department for training. We all, through the last, I've now been here for two budget cycles. You know, last year they started with zero in the training budget. We're trying to reinforce it. Now we're trying to guide that training experience a little bit more and give some incentive for people to get the proper certification. So I applaud. It's one of the first actions of the public safety director working with the two fire captains. So I'm pleased with how that came out. Also want to give a little thanks to your city attorney, Anita. I believe we culminated the negotiations with OCOT last week. So we'll hopefully have an executed agreement to share with you all shortly. Also want to point out that Mr. Gupta's birthday about a week ago. But more importantly, this will be his last council meeting with us as a city employee. And just want to give him some personal thanks and appreciation for the guidance and leadership that he's demonstrated. Your industrial pretreatment ordinance, which you approved earlier this evening, was a direct result of his curiosity, investigation, and determined nature in listening to support partners with Woodard Kern right here, and just want to thank you all for being here, Glenn and Justin and Joe. So part of the team, but not forgot. Also, I have the pleasure of announcing earlier today, Andrew Landis accepted the position of senior planner. He, amongst a variety of other things, was Tim Maswell's instructor at Rollins College, and has quite a bit of experience in sustainable agriculture and ecology in metropolitan green spaces. So we think he'll be a good fit in the senior planning position, and we anticipate him starting on the 30th, so quite soon. We have posted the fire chief position and already got several applicants, and also got some strong interest
somebody out there, another way to go online, it seems to be down here before we can see this, so it's good insights.
Thank you.
This is next up, Charles Wall, in the conference room over on the room.
We'd like to open space.
City attorney report?
I have no idea, just one question, so.
I have one question. Do we still have a lawsuit pending against us from Ridley Jones?
Yes, ma'am. They are pending, there's no activity, having occurred. The last record activity was, I believe, June or July of 2018.
Thank you.
Along those lines, maybe we could get an update, because there's another one, I think, out there as well, there's a couple of them around, so maybe just an update.
I'll do a quick report, absolutely. I will get an update out by the end of the week.
I have a question, I had spoken with the city manager, and he said he was going to be forwarding a news article to you about a federal judge in the Eastern District with the ADA lawsuits and all. Does that impact us in any way as far as being able to go back on that, or are we kind of a closed deal?
Yeah, that was already signed and approved. It really, I don't think, would have an effect anyway, but I'll give you more details when I send out the report later this week.
Any council comments? Hearing none, it is 7:34, and I am closing the council meeting.
That's a record. I still have that.